Greetings everyone, today I will show you how to install Invoke AI on your Windows computer, on RunPod and on MassedCompute. Additionally, I will show something new that I haven't shown before, how to use MassedCompute running applications in your PC like it is running in your local host. You see, this is local host URL, but it is running on the MassedCompute. It is amazing, just keep watching. I will begin with showing on the Windows, then MassedCompute, then the RunPod. You can check out the video description to find the accurate video chapters. So let's begin with installing into the Windows. Download the attachments from here. The link of this file will be in the description of the video. Move the zip file wherever you want to install. Extract the zip file. Enter inside zip file and double click and start the Windows install.bat file. You see, it is asking you to have Python 3.10 or Python 3.11, C++, CUDA, and also enable Windows long paths. So let's enable the Windows long paths from here, double click it. It will ask you a permission, then click yes here, and it will be done. Then click Windows install.bat file again, press any key. So for the requirements, I already have an excellent tutorial here. The link is here. Watch it, learn it. Also, for CUDA 12.4 and C++ tools, I have a new post. So you can also check it out if you encounter any issues. So after installer initialized, it will ask you some of the options. Just hit enter here. Hit again if it fails. Hit multiple times. Yes, now working. Okay, it is asking you to select the installation folder. I want to install wherever I started the bat file. So I deleted the folder path and hit enter here. It will ask you like this, hit yes and hit enter. Then it will ask your GPU. I have CUDA, so 1 and hit enter. And it will start the installation automatically for you. Just wait patiently. Okay, so the installation has been completed. It says installation successful. Press any key. Then when you return back to your folder, you will see invoke.bat file. This is the file. It will start Invoke AI. Double click it. Select the option 1. And that's it. It will start Invoke AI on your local Windows computer. It is downloading some of the necessary files and it is getting started. Okay, it is started. You see, this is the URL. UVCorn running on this URL. To open this URL, I am going to do click here, copy, go to your browser and paste, and Invoke AI started. You can set your models from models folder, scan folder, enter wherever the checkpoints you have. You can download models from starter models from here quickly, and then you can generate images from here. You need to select your model. Let's generate an image as an example. Then we will be moving. So I will scan this folder and I will use Juggernaut XL version 9. I will click. This is my existing model, but you can download quickly models from here. Just click plus icon and it will download them. Okay, then I go to the canvas. I have a prompt like a car. The model is selected. Invoke. Now it will start generating a model for me. You can see the progress on the CMD window. Okay, this is the speed. It is not a great speed if you ask my opinion on RTX 3090. And image generated. Okay, now I will move to the MassedCompute. Please use this link to register. Open it. After registering, setting up your billing, then go to the deploy. In here, select GPU. I suggest you to use RTX A6000 GPU. If this is not available, use RTX A6000 alt config. In some cases, it may not have enough RAM memory, then you can select 2. If you also need more space, you can increase the number of GPUs to have more disk space. Then select category creator, select SECourses. You see the current price is 1.25 because it is 2 GPUs, select 1. Now the price is 62 cents. After we apply our coupon SECourses, verify, it will become 31 cents for this amazing GPU and the machine. Then click deploy. Our coupon is permanent and our image is amazing. You will see it. So it is starting. Wait until the initialization has been completed. So I am going to use TinLinch drive. You can download it from here. It is so straightforward to install and use. Just set it up from here. Then open your TinLinch client from here. Go to options, go to local devices, drives, and set your synchronization folder. Set it as read and write. In the other tutorials, I explained it this in details. Okay, so the machine has started. Let's connect as usual. And from here, copy your IP and password and connect. Continue. Let's download the file again. Move it into your MassedCompute synchronization folder like this. Click start. MassedCompute deal is just amazing, amazing price, amazing powerful GPU, and amazing speed their machines have. You will see it. Go to the home, go to the thin drives, MassedCompute. This is my synchronization folder. Then find your zip file and drag and drop it into your downloads folder. Here, wait until copied. Yes, it is copied. Right click and extract here. Then enter inside this folder. You will see that it has MassedCompute instructions file. You really should read my instructions files. For installation, we are going to copy this command, open a terminal here, paste it, and hit enter. The installation is same as on Windows, actually. Just hit enter on this question, then delete this part so it will be installed wherever you have copy pasted your files. Hit enter, then hit yes and hit enter. If you get this message, just cancel it. Okay, I am going to use NVIDIA GPU, select one and hit enter, and it will start installation. Installation on MassedCompute is just super fast. Their machines are just super fast. Okay, so the installation has been completed. You see installation successful. Now we are going to start the Invoke AI. For starting it, copy this line, copy it, go to the installation folder, open a new terminal, paste it like this. Hit one and hit enter. Then you will see that it will start here. Okay, you see ubicorn running on. Let me zoom in to show you. Okay, here. So open this link and you can use it inside ThinLink client. However, it is not very fast. So if you want to use it on your computer with a secure way, we are going to follow the commands here. First of all, go back to your MassedCompute running instance, copy IP from here, you see, copy it, go back to your ThinLink client and change the IP address here to your IP address of your machine, then copy it, open a PowerShell in your Windows computer like this, paste it and hit enter, and it may ask you some questions. Just type yes, 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 then it will ask you the password. So for password, copy the password from here, it is copied, then return back to PowerShell, right click, then hit enter. So it will approve your connection. Okay, after that, to connect it, we are going to use this local URL. Since this SSH is running, then this local URL will be bound to the MassedCompute. So actually, this application is not running on my computer right now, but it is running on the MassedCompute right now. As usual, you can download the models from starter downloads, or you can scan the folders of the MassedCompute. So for MassedCompute folder, it is here. Just copy paste it and scan folder. You see it is running because it is running on the MassedCompute, not on my computer. Now I can add the models from here, or I can download any model I want from here. Actually, I'm going to show FluxDev download on the RunPod. It is same. There is no difference. Then go to the Canva and wait for models to appear. I think it is still adding. Yes, edit. Yes, now I should be able to select. Yes, selected. Then just hit invoke. You see it shows the queue and you can see the images are getting generated. I can see that on my MassedCompute. Yes, it is 5 IT per second, which is really, really good. You can see it here. So it is working amazing as expected. Now as a next step, I will use the RunPod. Okay. So for RunPod, use this link to register, please. Then let's log in, set up your billing and set some money, then deploy. You can use secure cloud, community cloud. I'm going to use secure cloud for faster setup. And I'm going to use US Texas 3. This is the fastest one. Then let's pick the 4090. Use this template. I didn't test other ones. So to select that template, type torch and RunPod torch 2.1. I am not sure if others will work or not. Set your volume disk as you wish. Let's set it 100 gigabytes. And you can use the proxy of RunPod to connect. So don't forget that 1991. Then set overrides and we are ready. Deploy on demand. then go to my pods. I already have a lot of tutorials for RunPod. You can watch them to learn how to use RunPod better. You can always message me and I will link you to the accurate tutorials. Just wait until connect button appears. So the connect button appeared. Let's connect. Connect from the JupyterLab interface. Let's download the model again. You see it is downloaded. Wait for JupyterLab to open. Okay, it's opened. So I am going to upload file. Select the downloaded Invoke AI zip file like this. Wait until upload completed. Yes, then right click and extract archive. So it will extract everything into here. Refresh. Then open RunPod instructions txt file. Copy this. Open a new terminal. Paste and hit enter. Then it will ask the options to us. Just wait. Okay, same as usual, just hit enter. I will delete this, so I want to install into the workspace. Hit enter, then type yes and hit enter, and then just we wait. Okay, then type the GPU NVIDIA, hit 1 and hit enter, and the installation started. Okay, so the installation has been completed on RunPod. Let's return back the RunPod instructions. Copy this and open terminal. I make my installers all same way, so once you learn one of them, it works for all. Hit 1 and hit enter. Wait until see the local started URL as usual. It shows our GPU, CodeNN version, and yes, you see local URL started. Then to connect and connect HTTP service port 1991. And it is started. Now I can use it. Currently I don't have any models, so I'm going to download a model from starter models. Let's download Flux Dev. Since this is a very powerful GPU, we can use it. So it is going to download its full size. You can also download quantized ones. You see the downloads is in progress. It is really, really fast. This machine is fast. Yes, it is downloading right now. So wait until all downloads completed and in progress is completed. It is hashing after downloading them, so it is taking some time. We can see that here on the CMD window, but it should be fast. So it is all completed. Let's generate an image. So I click here, then I go to the canvas. Now the Flux Dev is here. Let's type a prompt: amazing sports car, race car on the roads. Okay, something like this. It's not very important. Then we can see the speed generation here. It is first loading the checkpoint shards. Yes, pretty fast. It is fully utilizing the VRAM, you see, almost using entirely, and the generation speed is 1.6 IT per second. It is slower than the Swarm UI. With Swarm UI, you can use dash dash fast and generate images faster. But yes, it is here. So this is how you can install and run the Invoke AI on RunPod. I hope you have enjoyed. I am not expert of Invoke AI, but this is how you install them and start using them. Hopefully see you in future tutorials.